Had a little speed, and he'd be all right. And then Leroy King broke open the game, really, with a 46-yard touchdown run. And we were so pleased with Leroy. He'd been talked about as a power runner, but he showed that he can get out and do a little when he gets open, too. And Johnny Ham Jones, our one real veteran, shows why he is tough to handle when he's healthy. He gives you an extra dimension. As we go into the season, you see some of our young players here, like Donnie Little, on a quarterback draw, picking up about 12 yards in the first down. And here you see Donnie coming out behind Jim Yarbrough on a bootleg play and deciding to run and showing why he is such a powerful athlete to stop.
Well, I guess we should mention he's out at the Sun Bowl, but he is all right.
That's correct. We operated on his hand and he hurt in the Baylor game. And he will miss the Sun Bowl, but he'll be back for spring training. Another youngster is Brad Beck. He's a fullback type runner that's a slasher. And that gives you a good shot of our offensive line, which is just laced with young guys, including that running back there, A.J. Jones. He's also a slasher and a good, tough runner inside. Has good balance, and you can see he has power and strength. And once A.J. got his legs under him, as far as the program was concerned, he gave us some exciting football plays and some very tough runs. Brad back again behind the blocking of Terry Tausch and Wes Hubert, and Jim Yarbrough provided a little bit more excitement on those tough runs. And of course, great athletes have the ability to come up with great plays, and Johnny Lamb Jones was probably the most feared football player in the Southwest Conference. Randy McEachern then shows you how many receivers we actually went to, and he finds Les Studdard, our tight end, in the end zone for a touchdown. And then some more of that inside tough running. You see a great block there by Craig Ryder as Brad Beck picks up another big first down in a long touchdown drive against North Texas State. Again, to show you his determination, just see how he keeps going. He's a fine young little fullback, and we're pleased that he's going to be here for a while, too. And McEachern comes back again to his tight end on a crossing pattern with the coverage that people were giving Johnny Lamb Jones,
yeah.
Double and triple coverage. It opened up other receivers, and mainly it was our tight end. And you can see that slashing style is going to be a pleasure to watch for some time with Brad Beck and A.J. Jones. Then in a very big game against University of Arkansas that was televised, Johnny Lamb Jones got us going against a win. The score was tied, and he picks up 26 yards on a little hitch screen, and that just ignited our football team. McEachern then, in the same drive, came on back and hit Lawrence Sampleton, a freshman tight end.
Another one. Another
for
freshman.
A big, big pass play. And you see Randy again going to that big tight end, and Lawrence gets behind their defensive back, and Randy finds him. His first college touchdown. It's a great thrill for him against a quality opponent. It was a great day for us passing. With McEachern throwing to Johnny Lamb for a touchdown there. He goes back then late in the game on a big, big drive to give us the score that won the football game. He goes to Lawrence Sampling again for a 35-yard reception right down the middle, and then here's that same...
Perfect timing.
Jesse. Oh, yeah, perfectly timed pass to Johnny Lamb Jones, and that requires concentration. We were able to win that ball game due to our passing game. Then in a hard-fought game against SMU, A.J. Jones shows some more of that power running, cutting, slashing inside. That's that fullback type running. And Johnny Ham Jones just comes out of nowhere. I'll tell you, he's dangerous. He really is. He had health problems most of the fall, but we were so thankful to get him back for the Texas A&M game. He had a great game. He's a fine little competitor. And we watched our offensive line grow stronger and stronger as the season went on, even though we had a lot of injuries. The people we replaced our injured players with were improving every week. Donnie Little, and you saw him on an option run a moment ago, comes back then and scrambles around and finds his tight end in the end zone for a big score for us. That's Les Studdard. Donnie is a gifted runner. And people aren't aware of his passing ability. His execution of this reverse to Johnny Lamb Jones was really just perfect. In our first game against Rice, our defense set the tone for the season. We were demanding with a good pass rush. We were good tacklers, and plays like this one by Steve McMichael, who just played extremely well all fall, show you why people had a difficult time running on us in the middle. Again, McMichael is back in the backfield. He and Bill Acker provided some real force inside. Derek Hatchett comes up with a big interception, and he had been burned a couple times in the season. And, you know, it's I want to compliment Derek because he never lost his confidence, and he knew he was a good football player, and he just kept working and kept maintaining his pride, and he came up with some big defensive plays. Henry Lee Williams and Ricky Churchman combined there to come up with one of their big plays, and we saw they were very popular. We saw it all season long.
Ricky's fearless.
We put a lot of pressure on those passers, and Ron Bones there was the first to flush him out, and Dwight Jefferson came from the opposite side to make the tackle for no gain. Against Arkansas, I tell you, both teams played great defense. It was big play defense, too. It wasn't all offense. Here you see Ricky Churchman coming in at the last second to knock one away. And then on the very next play in this drive, they tried to go deep because they had the wind. And Derek Hatchett comes across, and he knocks one up into the air. I'd felt a lot better if they knocked it down. But the fact is they were covering very well and coming up with a big plays when we had to have them.
There's another one by Derek.
Another fine play by Derek Hatchett. Now, that's a lot of pressure, I'll tell you. And talk about pressure. Ryan Bones was there to flush him out, and then Steve McMichael made him go wider, and Robin Sinline finally gets his body right in the middle of the quarterback and threw him for a loss. But you just keep watching on these passes and see the heat that those quarterbacks are under, and that creates interceptions like this one by Johnny Johnson. That was his first of the day, and he wasn't aware of that defender. He was close to returning that one all the way. Great view of what it looks like to face Lance Taylor.
Look at all those orange jerseys.
I tell you, you're talking about someone that can anchor the line of scrimmage. Steve McMichael and Dwight Jefferson and Lance Taylor in the middle. They're really tough football players. We're mobile, as you can see here, by Robin Sinline and Henry Lee Williams getting that man corralled for a loss. And then McMichael's puts some pressure on, and Johnny Johnson comes from his free safety position and moves a long way, come up with his second interception, and that was a big one. That was in the fourth quarter and helped us secure the win. More pressure as Ron Bones is the first one to get to him, and Henry Lee Williams, Steve McMichael, and finally Steve comes up with a big recovery. And don't you think he wasn't happy at that point, but not nearly as happy as I was over on the sideline. Then we faced a very potent passing offense from SMU, and our defense was superb. Johnny Johnson continued to intercept, and our defensive line put more pressure on Ford than I believe he had seen all year, and more than they could handle. Bruce Schultz comes up with a big defensive play on a pass in his area, and our linebackers play a lot of pass defense. We had a great day that day. You can see the pressure. That's Ron Bones flushing him out, and Steve Massey, defensive tackle, drops him for a loss. One of the biggest plays was made by Bruce Schultz, who came in and hit him just right to keep him out of that end zone. And that was the final play of a four-play defensive goal line stand. They had it first and goal on our one, and we kept them out of there. Another big play by Derek Hatchett. He's outside one-on-one, man-to-man. He's able to reach up and knock the ball away. And the times that our defensive backs covered him very well, we were able to get the quarterback sacks. Ricky Churchman, who seemed to be at the right place at the right time all season long, recovered a big fumble, and see the pressure? Dwight Jefferson is the one that finally, you know, that gets him by the ankle, but it's of our kicking game. I want you to understand that it's an 11-man game, but what a great talent Russell Lurch laid them in. As you can see here, he's a tremendous punter, and he punts it down into a position where we're able to stop it inside the 5-yard line. In fact, on the one here against Texas A&M, and of course, Russell has the long distance capability as a field goal kicker with this 59-yarder, also against A&M. It was his longest of the season. And they're all valuable. But as a punter, he gave us some plays this year that that were just spectacular. And of course, the great coverage that we had with guys like Charlie Veslovic and Scott Huntington and Kenneth Sims and Adrian Price and Chuck Holloway, it was just great.
Really is a team effort, isn't it?
It is. Field position is talked about too little, in my opinion, and of course, field position comes from your kicking game. But it's not all just one way. We have a lot of pride in our return game also, and anytime you have someone like Johnny Johnson that is capable of great things returning the ball, and he'd be the first to tell you that everything he does depends on his teammates coming back in there to set the wall. But when we played SMU, which you just saw this return in, the kicking game was, the biggest thing we had going as far as moving the ball, because we had several returns in the game that we came close to breaking. And look at the field just fly by in this screen. And that kind of yardage is hidden. It's not, you don't see it in offensive statistics, you know, but it's very valuable yardage.
Here's one.
And what a super return man Johnny Lamb Jones has turned out to be this year. And this one was the highlight of our return game as far as kickoffs. It was over 100 yards. It'll go in officially as a 100-yard return, but he broke the game wide open with that.
Western philosophy. At the center, the players were all pulling on a rope together. And if one player let go, then that player would let the whole team down. Hang on to that rope became the catchphrase for the 75 Oilers, and I'll be dead gum if it didn't work. Why, those fancy dudes went out and won themselves a corral full of games and came within a cactus needle of putting their brand on the playoffs. This is the way it was.
No one guy builds anything. I don't build this team. Our assistant coaches and our offense and our defensive people, they're the ones that do it. I just happen to be the head coach.
This football team's got a little something going for them that a whole lot of people don't have. The thing they got going for them is togetherness. And if you got that, you got a chance. Without it, you don't have a chance.
I had to give them a description of the type of guy that I wanted. And the only way I could explain the doggone thing was in the form of like two mountain climbers climbing on a mountain and one of them slips and falls. And we know that the guy that fell is not going to let go of the rope. What we wanted was someone on the other end of that rope that we knew wouldn't let go of it. So what we did it for was an effort to make everybody realize that the guy next to them was the kind of guy that they'd bet their life on. But holding on to the rope was something that lasted all year long.
So the Houston Oilers got set to try out a brand new coach with a different way of talking. When things got tough, Bum just said,